I have had The Last of Us for PS3 sitting on my shelf for what feels like forever. Seriously. I bought it day one when it came out way back in 2013 and was extremely hyped for it. I'm pretty sure I pre-ordered it and went to pick it up and could not wait. I was really into the Uncharted games, and at the time, I really liked The Walking Dead. And so, a game by Naughty Dog that was post-apocalyptic and cinematic sounded like a dream come true. Then I played it. I played, like, maybe 5 hours? Great start, beyond emotional opening, my God. I was feeling it. And then I was just like, I don't know. Something about the first portion of the game was a little boring to me. It's the stuff I don't care for when it comes to zombie stuff. Military dudes, smuggling, I don't know. It really just got kind of boring to me. I also didn't care for the stealth aspect because I'll be honest with you, I'm just a guns blazing kind of person. I don't kind of think about it. My husband loves stealth and enjoys stuff like Hitman, but for me, it's more story and constantly hiding or having to worry about whether or not to use the one of the two bullets you have. Not for me. Not for me, guys. I want to be able to constantly reload and not worry about it. Problem is, that is not what this game is. I remember getting to a part with a bloater, one of those extremely gross infected people that's just so far gone, it's disgusting, and I just quit. And then, now it's 2021, and here I am, and I just beat it on PlayStation 4. I really wanted to get back into this game because the sequel came out last year and did really well, and the series seems to be a staple at this point, and I've changed a lot as a gamer since, well, 2013, so I figured it was worth revisiting. Just straight up quitting The Last of Us? I don't know, it just didn't sit right with me. My friend Matthew was kind enough to send me his copy of the game, and so why wait? So I decided to play it now. I just beat Persona 5 Royal, as you guys know, and I spent over 100 hours on it. So a game that was about 15 hours sounded perfect. So here I am playing it again, and to be honest with you, I'm having a bit of the same feelings as I did back in 2013. I am a bit bummed because I'm really wanting to like this game. Everyone says it's a masterpiece. What's up with that? What's wrong with me? So I keep going. I get through some of the drier parts at the beginning and I meet up with Ellie again and she joins the fun and then all of a sudden, I don't know, just starts to click. I start to connect with it. I feel like, okay, I'm starting to like these characters. I learned some neat stuff about Ellie, and just like that, I'm invested. I need to know what happens. I am truly rooting for these characters now. And in these types of games, it's really about the story and the characters. Honestly, it's like if you hear a great musician who has the talent to play super well or sing really well, but then they play a terrible song, it doesn't matter if Frank Sinatra sings. If it's a shitty song, it's a shitty song. Cinematic games like this thrive on having a well-told story, and so when this game really started to open up and I found myself wanting to know more and really just wanting to know how this was all going to play out, I realized I liked it. I liked this game. I also truly love it when you want the characters to succeed, because at that point the game becomes kind of real. Like, these characters are real people experiencing real events and real emotions. You can't wait to turn the game on because you're going to learn something new each play session, or something crazy is going to happen. You don't know what it is, and that's the excitement of it all. Now, just as a side note here, I don't want to spoil anything, but I will say that this game ended in a way I did not think it would. Maybe it's just me and I had a different idea of how everything was going to play out, but I was pleasantly surprised, and I really liked that. Lots of times stories are pretty predictable, but for some reason this one wasn't, for me. I thought something was going to happen, and it didn't. What that is something I'll keep to myself, or if you've beat it, you can ask me about it, so I'll leave it at that. In terms of music, I'll be completely honest here, I played this game at a very low volume, because every time I played it, my son was usually sleeping, and most of the games I can have at a decent level, But this one was a lot of gunshot sounds. So the characters and the music would always be at a normal level. And then all of a sudden you'd hear gunshots and it just was so loud. So I always had this game turned down a lot. So I really didn't get to enjoy the score the way I usually do in games, but it didn't take away from the experience. I can always listen to it on my own to appreciate it. But yeah, just something to note. The Last of Us has been this game kind of staring at me for years now. I've always seen the PS3 copy on my shelf and not really known what to do with it because I haven't really played the PS3 for a long time, nor do I plan on playing it or using it anytime soon. I knew the remastered version was out there, but based on my experience back in 2013, I wasn't really in a rush to play this. But then I got this urge to just do it. And thank goodness my friend sent me the copy that he did, which allowed me to just get on it and do it. The last 10 to 15 years have been an overload of zombie and post-apocalyptic movies and TV shows and books and pretty much every piece of media. Kind of like when vampires were just shoved down our throats. So zombie stuff has been a bit of a bore to me lately, I guess. But this really did a great job. No zombies per se, kinda? You just have to play it to see. It was a different take on the genre and yet not at the same time. Lots of typical stuff. Military zones, bad bunches of people who want to kill your little group of people. Walking Dead much. Random zombie scares. People dying. The huge. But it was really compelling. Joel and Ellie's story was interesting, and I really liked the two of them together. It just worked. It definitely will make a good TV show, and I mention that because it's being filmed where I live, so that's really cool. If you're like me, and it's 2021, and you've still not played this, do it. The remastered version is really cheap, it looks great, plays great, it's accessible, no excuses, and yes, there's an easy mode for people like me. I am not into stealthy games, so the difficulty options were nice to have because it's not my usual affair, having said that you know me and I usually play all my games on easy anyway, so whatever. This game is just good. Is it my favorite game ever? Or a top 5? No, but that's fine. It was incredible though, and I'm very excited to get the second one soon and check that out. I have pretty high hopes and I think it'll deliver. Have you played this game? What did you think? I would love to hear everyone's thoughts on The Last of Us, considering it's super fresh to me, and I really liked it. Remember to click like, comment, and subscribe for more little discussions on games like this, and of course, all the other fun videos I do. I'll see you guys in my next video.